teacher is fired after writing racial slur on a whiteboard. Where there are plenty of good teachers out there. This is not one of them, apparently. Las Vegas substitute teacher has been immediately fired after a photo posted online showed him writing the N-word on a Silvestri Junior High School whiteboard. What in the world would possess? Okay. Students from Charles Silvestri Junior High alerted their principal, Yvette Tippetts, and other administrators about one of her staffers being at the center of the racially volatile tweet. The unidentified male teacher was seen speaking to students with the word on the whiteboard, according to the Las Vegas Review-Journal. Picture was posted on the No Racism in Schools #1865 page for all to see. School's principal, Yvette Tippetts, released a statement to parents informing them that the school had launched an investigation into an issue that, quote, involved communication that contained racial implications. You think, Miss Tippetts, you think? Administration will continue to communicate with you about these situations because it will take the entire Silvestri Junior High School community to condemn these actions collectively, the principal promised. I assure you that appropriate action will be taken against those responsible based on the outcome of the investigation. Additionally, I would like you to know that this will not be tolerated at our school or within the school district. We will not tolerate behaviors that contradict an inclusive community and impact the needs of our students. Liz Guzman, one of the Clark County School Board trustees, tweeted this. The district has removed this individual. They will no longer be able to substitute at any school in the Clark County School District. I want to commend the students that turned in this horrific act. It allowed the district to move swiftly. Parents applauded the district for taking this incident seriously. One parent tweeted this. As a parent of a Silvestri kiddo, I'm glad this was taken seriously and there were immediate consequences for this individual who has no place in a classroom with our kids. Proud of the kiddos who spoke up. Well, this is lovely, Benny. I think, unless you heard something otherwise, I find this response lovely. And there's really not much there that I can, and you know, I like to like pick apart things. I think they handled this just right. I still want to know why homeboy was writing the N-word on the whiteboard. What was that about?
Yeah, most definitely. And every time I see something like this, my first thought is like, there's no way this is the first person this guy's done this, right? Like, because like, of course it's not going to be the first time, right? I mean, maybe. It could possibly be the first time that substitute's done it. But, right, like, you don't get to the point where you're doing things like that without sort of escalating and feeling the waters and getting to that point, right? And we live in a deeply racist society, right? And unfortunately, a lot of people that have worked in schools across the United States of America have been very comfortable doing a lot of really, really horrible stuff. I mean, I remember just a couple years ago, there was like a story about a school where like a teacher had done like a slave auction in the school, like as like some sort of like historical teaching moment, which obviously wasn't really a teaching moment. I guess except for the teachers that were dealing with that situation when they realized that that there wasn't really educational value in that, and people responded publicly. But the administration here was clearly just doing the right thing in terms of like responding immediately, firing the teacher, making sure that they're not going to be, you know, working with a school district anymore. And that sends a positive signal, because now if there's any other like potentially racist teacher that might want to substitute there, they know that they won't be able to get away with stuff. And so that's very good. But I guess the unfortunate reality is there's a lot of like sort of really awful stuff that happens in schools yep. across the United States, because unfortunately racism is just very normalized in our society and people think that they can get away with a lot.
Yeah, racism, bigotry, you name it. You name the other group that is targeted to this. And I agree with you. There's just one thing that's missing. And I don't know if the school's helping. We all remember that one moment as a child that we never really got over, that changed, you know, altered our view altered perhaps even our happiness. And so when you have people like this, perhaps not vetted enough, who end up in the classroom with impressionable young minds and kids who deserve better, okay, all kids deserve better. How do you undo that? Because I don't think you can, Benny.
Yeah. Unfortunately, like, the best thing you can do is what the school, like, did. And hopefully there was a follow-up directly with the students, right? Because the most important thing after the fact, after there's a situation like this that happens with kids, you know, somebody does or says something, like, racist or, you know, like, bigoted in some way, is to quickly get rid of the teacher and then respond by going to the students and saying, hey, we have your backs. You're safe here. This is fine. And we're going to respond appropriately to make sure this doesn't happen again. So at very least, they can have faith that the institutions are going to be there to, like, protect them from this happening again.
Exactly right. I think you're exactly right, Benny.